Let's take a look at my 1987 Chrysler LeBaron Turbo Coupe Premium. It's not too many coupes still around anymore. It took me a while to find this one. I just love the way that these look. I wish that there were more of these still around. Fortunately, all the LeBarons, and in fact, whenever anybody just says LeBaron, everybody always thinks it's a convertible. But the body lines and the styling of the coupe can't be beat. Full with taillights. Unfortunately, they didn't design the whole thing to light up. The only thing that lights up on this is this guy right here, and then you can see the line right there where the bulb is, just there, and of course the one on the end. So only the ends of it light up, plus a little bit of the sides of the middle piece. And I suppose it shows its wear. The original paint all over the car, and the trim here is starting to chip up in multiple areas. That's a pretty easy fix, and the main stuff is all here. Has the original twin pipe exhaust. Sounds really good. Clear lenses. Nothing is cracked, faded, or broken. Good view there of the side. Straight body. I have a bug right here. Let's get him off there. There we go. I believe that this was the peak in Chrysler's design. The original pinstriping is not looking too good all these years later. Once again, it's a pretty easy fix. It has, at some point, somebody decided to put this pinstriping here below the trim. I guess that looks neat, I'm not sure. I'm indifferent about it. But it is also coming off in a lot of places. The original 15-inch eggshell wheels, they're in pretty okay shape. No curb rash. It's a clean rim all around. They could definitely stand to be refinished. I have new Uniroyal tires on here all the way around. Good shape. Real chrome trim here on the fender flares. There's plastic stuff here on the trim, and that looks okay, I guess. Interesting thing about the coupes is I guess to make it look a little spicy or something, they added this decorative trim piece here as the Pinto star there at the bottom. Unfortunately, mine on both sides are pretty cracked. They're well, I guess they're shattered from the inside. It's smooth to the touch. I've been told that somebody remakes these. I'll have to research that. Turbo electronic fuel injection. Aside from the pinstripes, the paint, original paint, is in really nice shape. I wax it about every 3 months. It still has a really nice reflection to it. As you can see the hood there, how pristine that reflection is. Original windshield, all original gloss all around. It's all in really good shape. Look at that. Neat stuff. I put, the first thing I did when I got this car was I put brand new Rain-X wiper blades on it. It actually still had the original wiper blades. I don't think this car was driven in the rain before, prior to my ownership. They definitely looked crusty, and I didn't want to run those, risk scratching the windshield. That is bird poop. That just happened right now. Great. The wheels are all in about the same condition all around. They all could use a redo, but I guess some are better than others. This is the premium, which is the top trim level of the LeBaron, and how you can always spot a premium against the other trim levels is the premium came with this cornering lamp. This comes on with the turn signal. Helps you see better when you're turning. Whereas a lot of LeBarons don't have that. That's how you can tell it's a premium or not. I think there was three trims. Base, highline, and premium. Premium was the only one that got the cornering lamp, and it's a really useful feature. I wish more cars had that, especially when you've got limo tint on like I do. If it weren't for the pinstriping, this would look really nice. We've got a few little rock chips here on the front. Here you can see I tried to remove the original pinstriping in this area, and you can see underneath what it looks like. You can even see the lines in the paint where the pinstriping was. It's neat. So, yeah, you've got typical road rash, I suppose, on the front here, but good. No cracks, no dings or dents here. You have the nice chrome waterfall grill here. This is the only damage on the entire car is right here. You can see they hit something with it. We have a dent, I guess it's more of a ding, in the area where they got some paint rubbed off. And down here, they also beat up the trim a little. But like all the trim on this car, I'd repaint it. Repaint it black or white, whatever. This is all original. I'd say it's in pretty good shape for being 36 years old. This car has the original power antenna, which was working about a month ago. The motor still works, but the gearing inside that drives this rod up and down stripped out. So when you turn the radio on, you still hear the motor trying to wind up. So thankfully the motor does still work. You just gotta replace the gearing. And it would go up like that. Since it broke, I'm trying to keep it down to not damage it. Cowl looks nice. Let's take a look inside. Mirrors are all in good shape. All the rubber trim is actually in really nice shape. All around the car. Has the door handle here and has illuminated a key ring, which is useful at night. Probably can't see it right now. This car is white on blue leather interior, which in my opinion, it's definitely the color scheme to have. You can see the dash lights up there when you open up the door. It goes off in a bit. This interior, I think, is just absolutely gorgeous. We have full leather interior here with the buckets. Leather steering wheel. This car is fully loaded with every available factory option. Weather stripping's all in good shape. It's all nice and moisturized. This has the automatic, in quotes, seat belts, which you can take off pretty easily by just pressing there. And then you can take them out and put them away if you decide to. Do that right now. Just put that, tuck that down in there. There we go. Now you can enter a little easier, I suppose. Got lights on the door. You can see everything's in really good shape. No rust on the doors at all. This car was a Florida car, since new. I am the first person to do, drive it outside of Florida. I just moved up to Georgia about 3 months ago, and I drove this car to Georgia. It was about a 6-hour drive, no issues. It's a really nice driving car. We have 6-way power seat adjustments, power mirrors, power locks. Let's see that seat go, There it goes. And you can move it all these different ways. Oh. It's raising up the rear. Alright. All that works. I have the little knob that goes on for the mirrors, but you can see there it goes. Makes a funny noise when you do it to the right. Power door locks on the other side there. Cool stuff. I love the way that this interior is designed. The blue with all the square and the wood grain everywhere. Let's take a look in the back. For a coupe, this is a really comfortable back seat. Like, they really designed you to use it. This can seat 5 people. Really thick, nice, plush, shag-like carpet all around. I've got the original floor mats here underneath there. Pretty clean. It's all nice stuff. No tears, no rips, no cracks, no nothing. And all the leather upholstery. What's interesting is these headrests are actually adjustable in the back here. Let's see if I can do it one-handed. There, I've moved it up. I think that's kind of neat. You can move them up and down if you want. And we've got locks back here. These seats actually fold down flat. And you can fit a lot in this car. I've actually moved half of my stuff in this car on the way up here. Got a fold down armrest there. It's nice and soft and plush. All good stuff. I have a heat shield, sun visor all in here that I custom ordered for this car. Fits perfectly in the windshield. They say that it keeps the interior 30 degrees cooler inside. I guess that's so. I haven't tested that scientifically yet. Anyway, let's look. Original floor mats. You have your trunk release and gas cap release there. Carpet looks nice underneath. Sitting in the 1987 Chrysler LeBaron coupe. This car, like I said, is fully loaded. Check this out. It has the voice. This car talks. It, the Kit Knight Rider. Check this out. I'm going to turn on my headlamps here. Just pull this knob forward and watch what happens over here.
Your headlamps are on.
How cool is that? I'll turn them off. It reminds you, it verbally tells you, your headlamps are on, your keys are in your ignition, fuel reminders, tells you about washer fluid, brake fluid, transmission, and brakes, and coolant, and oil, and all that sort of stuff. It's very useful. We'll go ahead and put the key in the ignition and start it up here. Just giving you an overview. Got cup holders down here. Little storage bin down there. Has a speed control, which actually works. Tilting steering wheel. Alrighty. I have 2 trunk keys that also operate locking the rear seats. I also have 2 ignition keys.
Your keys are in the ignition.
How cool is that? Okay, check this out. Try to get all of it here in frame. Look at that. Isn't that cool? Full digital instrumentation this is the future right here. You have these buttons over here that allow you to control the dash. We can switch to trip. There's the trip odometer. There's the regular mileage. We're at 72,978. We can switch over to metric. There's the kilometers. And back to US. Have trip reset. I don't want to do that. Then we have gauge select, and this is cool. This changes this guy down here. Let's see here. So that's your battery voltage. Press it again. There's oil pressure. Press it again, and you're back to the temperature. Neat stuff. And then over there, you've got fuel. Tachometer on the top. Okay, let's close the door. So we have this advanced trip computer here. Does all of that stuff. We can press one of these buttons. Wow. Somebody test drove it today and they did a good job of ruining my fuel economy. Some of these you gotta press a little hard. Well, there you go. Show all this different stuff here. It's cool. Systems check monitor. If I went and fastened my seat belt, that would go off. Let's see what that looks like. Oh, it wants a shoulder belt too. Oh, there you go. Monitored systems okay. Cool stuff. That's a button and it doesn't work, but it would go through all of the different messages it can say. We have the electronic climate control here. It's a nice feature. All these buttons you can see are in nice shape. Nothing's worn off. We can turn on the AC here. Get a little snow. AC blows ice cold in here. I have it set to 72. If I have it any lower, it actually is pretty freezing. I've updated the radio from a newer Chrysler, I think from the late 90s. It gives you more features than the original radio did. We have CD and cassette, some other cool stuff. The original radio I still have, it's a 5-band equalizer one, just cassette only. This has the deluxe 6-speaker sound system in it. All original speakers. This was before Infinity was an available option for audio systems, and the Infinity sounds really good. Really, really freaking good. But this car is actually predates that partnership. It's just kind of interesting to know. But the original 6-speaker deluxe sound system actually sounds pretty good, especially with this newer head unit. CD. Got one of those in there right now. Equalizer lights up. Got the joystick there to adjust the fade and balance. Sounds really good for a stock sound system for 1987. You've got tweeter mid-ranges up here in the dash. I'd say they're probably about 3 inches. The one over there, that is the one that says the voice messages along with music. We have, I guess these would be mid-bass in the doors here. And in the back are 2 6x9 full range woofers. And that's most of your sound output. We've got little lights around the side. Let's see if I can turn those on. Maybe not. Let's see here. There you go. You can also twist those on. The headliner is new. Two map lights up here. These both work good. Original manual dimming rear view mirror. Like I said before, the windshield is in perfect condition. There that is. Do it at 74,000, and we're going to be hitting 73,000 here. Then next time I drive this, I'm sure. On back at the center console, we have ashtray of the cigarette lighter. There is the cap here, the knob that goes on the mirror controls, just needs to be re-glued. And the lighter works. I use it all the time with my FM transmitter. This car is equipped with a 3-speed automatic. I believe they call it the torque flight. There's drive, and you've got those. So all of that is good. Power windows. They work really good. You can see how dark my tint is. It's good to have. There's a good stuff. Both sun visors, the fabric isn't in that great of shape, haven't replaced that. They both have illuminated vanity mirrors. There they are. Get that to focus. Well, anyway, you get the idea. On both sizes like that. I'll roll down the window a bit. You can hear the dual tone horn. Well, one of them occasionally works. What else can we play with in here? Oh, you have, this is for your rear defroster. I think the mirrors, side mirrors are also heated. There's your armrest here. It's pretty nice and soft, actually. You can open that up. You have a spot there for cassettes and whatever else. I have the original lighter in here. You can see that's never been used. That's pretty good storage, I suppose. And then in the back you have rear passengers are treated to an ashtray. You can see that's never been used. And there's the LeBaron logo there on the dash. The dash is in mint shape. Everything's in really like new condition with this car. Lockable glove box, illuminated. It's kind of small, but I've got all my service sheet seats in there, as well as the owner's manuals booklet. That's what the passenger door has. Okay, let's go for a drive. Go ahead here and shift her in the drive. And off we go. Let's see here. This has the 2.2 liter turbo, four cylinder. Look at all those geese. Wow. Okay, we're good both ways. This car is the 1987, which means that it has the Turbo 1 engine. I think 1988 got the famous Turbo 2, which is more powerful. Looks like we're going to be here for a while. All right, let's go for it. It's not even full throttle because traffic does not really permit for that. But you can see she definitely goes, even in her old age. Let's go for it again. Downshift. Transmission shifts perfectly. Car's going down the road, you can see, at about 60 miles, and we're doing really good. This car does not have traction control. It's too old for that. Also does not have ABS. It's too old for that too. But I just replaced the entire brake system on it, so everything stops really good. This has been my main car for about 6 months now. And it's been very reliable. Like I said, I drove it here from Florida. I'm in Georgia right now. I drove it from my town of St. Augustine, Florida, up to Gainesville, Georgia. And it made that drive no stops. I've driven it, I think I've driven it longer distances. And it always does really good. Never have a doubt. It's a smooth cruiser for sure. It definitely goes down the road really well. And the air conditioning and the heater. Everything works in this car 100%. It's kind of amazing. But, there's not a single thing in this car that doesn't work, as I think I've just shown you. I have the AC on, and you can't tell it, but I'm at a very comfortable temperature right now. I think it's probably around 80 degrees out right now, and I have it set to 72, and that's plenty cold for me. Cut on the turn signal here and show you that works. The flickering in the dash is just the frame rate not matching up with the phone. Anyway, that's it. Before I forget, gotta show the headlights. Quad, like a boss. See if you can see the lids close.